Okay, so it's Thursday. We got natural gas numbers, EIA numbers, inventories coming out at 10:30 Eastern time. It is just after 10:20, so we got 10 minutes until those numbers come out. I have the natural gas contract up here on the left. We're looking at the June contract, currently trading at 273. Gotten a little downside action early this morning already. And just pulling this back even a little bit further. Pretty remarkable when you just back it up to, you know, we're up there over 280, 7 pennies higher just at couple days ago. So 273 is where we're currently sitting, and we just traded down in, realistically, I mean, call it the last hour and a half, from under 275. So I went into our commodity spreads. I started with the 11 AMs to see what kind of options we had in here. And what's going to happen is that they're going to be priced starting at 275. And that's because that's where we were just trading at,
right,
as these kind of got launched, whether it's in the 9 till 11s, which is what we're looking at here, or we'll pull up next the 10 a.m. till the noons. They're going to have the same exact price points, okay? So we're going to be able to have a spread that goes from 275 to 295.
Yeah.
And what we're going to try and set up here is a volatility trade. We'll be buying the bullish spread, 275 to 295. I have that one up right here. We'll be selling the bearish spread, 275 down to 255, each one representing 20 cents a movement. And what's important to note here is that with the contract trading at 273, you're going to have that intrinsic value on the bearish spread,
right? Right?
Because you're 2 pennies underneath, which is going to represent approximately 20 ticks. They take
right.
in 1/10 of a penny. So this contract is going to be about $200 in total,
yep.
right? So we're going to be selling this contract, and that's where you get your 200. Your max loss versus your profit is going to combine to equal to 200. So that's going to be the expensive one because you have to pay for that intrinsic value,
yes.
which right now represents $18 of that 23 that you're paying, right? Because that is
yep.
your, am I looking at
16
that?
16 to $10.
Yeah,
right.
Thank you.
It
yes.
keeps moving around.
It does keep
yeah,
moving,
right.
yeah, exactly. It's the difference from 275
yeah.
down to 273.1,
right.
call it now.
Right.
Yeah, so it is. 273 would be $20,
yeah.
and so it's at $19 of intrinsic value plus a little premium. And then on the flip side, you have no intrinsic value on the bullish spread because you're out of the money, and you're just paying premium, which is the 7 ticks above the floor of that spread.
Right.
275.7. So it's looking about $30 for the 11 amps.
It's not bad.
No, not bad.
3 pennies.
Three pennies, and you would need the 3 pennies away from 275. So what's especially intriguing is if you're a little bit bearish, you only need to trade down to 272.
Right.
Because, and just, you know, common sense-wise, all you have to do is make up the bearish spread, right?
The bullish spread.
But, you know, if you're going to break even to the positive side, you need to trade 3 pennies above 275. So you need to trade 278.
And this is the 11 o'clock one.
These are the 11 o'clocks, all right? So those are the 11s, and then I had already pulled up the noons, okay? So same exact prices.
Which is great.
On the bullish side, pretty much same exact premium here, right? It was 275.7,
yep.
same exact premium. And on the bearish side, very similar.
Look at that.
Very similar.
Now, that's really sweet. You're getting an extra hour for only 2 pennies.
Yeah.
Pretty much, right.
Two pennies in the contract,
right.
You know, $2 on,
yeah.
but basically $1 per side is all they're adding for
right.
that extra
right.
Hour with the inventory numbers due in about 6 minutes. So that's not bad either. You'd be looking, especially if you're a little bit bearish, right?
Yeah.
Now, you don't need to be because you have exposure to both sides. But as you can see, just from that example, you know, if you're putting up $32, which represents 3.2 pennies away from that 275 point, you can see that you have a head start to
the
downside.
273. Right?
Yeah. So that's especially nice if you might be looking for a little bit of a bearish reaction. You've already gotten some negative reaction. But the other side of that is you could be looking for a pop in the same essence,
sure.
right back up to where you are. So depending on what you're looking at, for sure. But we'll get those numbers in 6 minutes from right now, possible trade setups, and see how that fares.
I love it. Natural gas. Let's see what we got out here. So
okay. So they got the numbers. It looks like stockpiles rising 62 billion cubic feet. Expectation was a rise of about 51 billion cubic feet. Not too surprising via the expectation. We'll jump back over here. And there we go.
Look
Quite
at that.
A little decline.
Wow.
So to drill this down a little further. So
they finally got an injection.
What would have been nice about this, had you made this trade, is that we had the head start to the downside.
Right.
right? And that's the move that you got initially. So here are our noon spreads we're looking at. There's your 275 to 255. Bearish spread, of course, having all the value right now because the bullish spread's now almost 5 pennies out of the money.
Yep.
So you could right now buy that back and get their one contract. So $47. And that was going to cost us about 32. This
yeah.
is the noon one.
Oh, good. 32. Yep. Okay, cool.
And yeah. And, you know, what's intriguing there is you lock in about a 50% profit if you had made that trade. And you would still have this trade open for the next hour and a half if you happen to get a turnaround. And, you know, it's not likely, but guess what? It's not out of the realm. We were just at 275 as of less than 2 hours ago.
Right.
And you know, realistically, not too much of a miss in terms of the expectation. A little bit more than they thought, which would, you know, see some price action to the downside. But still, pretty interesting. We'll see where it shakes out, but a little action to the downside right off the bat. Not bad.
Now the coffers just keep getting filled all summer.
More natural gas, man.
Yeah.
There you go.
Natural gas.
Let's check back in. So we're at about 50 past the hour. And currently kind of hanging right where we were. That first move was the move that's kind of held.
Right.
270.07. So still, this would be our bearish spread, right? That's where all the value is on any kind of trade we're looking at. If you wanted to close out the trade, you could buy that back. Still right now, you're looking at collecting about $41. That trade for both legs of it would have cost us about $32. And then, you know, the nice thing about that is that, you know, it might not be likely, but you got over an hour and that contract stays active. And if you happen to get a move back up to anywhere near 275, you start getting value to the positive side while already locking in a profit to the negative side.
Yeah.
So not bad. Big time. Definitely.